sword is acquired, and with it will hope burn bright. Well, I care, according to next chapter, it will. This is only a chapter of, well, you know, author trying to navigate through the Camelot, reaching the holy sword. We still do not know what it is, but everyone seems to imply that once he has that sword, even the demons of the Ten Commandments won't be able to defeat them. Well, who knows? Yes, this is the Nanatsu no Taizai chapter 254, and I am the Angry Defender's Barrier. Seldrus returns, revealing that he could not get the commandments, but that they are in the hands of Merlin. And also mildly, and also informs that the four archangels have been revived, which Seldrus mildly taunts his older brother with the fact that Elizabeth has joined force with them. Elsewhere, Garland is still petrified after a long time. Estarosa finally finds him, but refuses to redo the petrification. All he does is killing him, confirming my theory that yes, the biggest threat is not Seldrus, it is Estarosa. This widely confirms my theory that he is more power-hungry than you think he is. I guess in the end, it won't be long now before Derere and Moonspieto are also killed. Well, so much for Garland. I felt like he had potential, although technically he did show a lot of that before. He just got petrified, so then he had served his purpose. With that, the commandment of the truth is now in the hands of Estarosa. It switches to Arthur, who is navigating the place, dodging demons, as his cat suddenly disappears. Turns out Arthur is trapped in an illusion made by Peronia, but Kaith finds her and surprisingly eats her. Well, so much for her. Once again another character that's pretty wasted pretty quickly. And then the strangest thing happened. I mean, I do not complain that much about it, but even Seldrus seems to find it surprise. Is that as Arthur walks in the corridor, suddenly Seldrus calls out to him and wonders why are you in this place. And even asks why his commandment didn't react to him. Is this meant to imply that Arthur is immune to the commandments of the Ten Commandments? I mean, he is Merlin's apprentice. Merlin could very well have casted something on him to make him immune to the Ten Commandments. Or is it just that Arthur is a child of fate so much, then what happens? Either way, he gets surrounded by both Seldrus and his master. See, as Seldrus realizes that Arthur is after the sword. So, Kaith creates a distraction by using telekinesis to temporarily stop them. As finally, after a long while, Arthur reaches the sword, who is unscathed. Unfortunately, a large explosion happens as Kaith is badly wounded, almost to the point of death. It's then that Meliodas shows himself and confirms and says to them all that do not hurt him further. But he, in the end, confirms to Arthur that he has severe ties with the Seven Deadly Sins and he's no longer the Man of News. Arthur, crying tears of remorse hearing that, surprisingly quickly says that he has always looked up to him, and have you already forgotten the words that you said to me, that what's important isn't how others think, it's how you think of others. And even no matter the circumstances, you betrayed the Seven Deadly Sins who always believed in you, and as well as betrayed your love, Princess Elizabeth. For that I will never ever forgive you, says Arthur as he lifts the holy sword up and she shines bright. Is this meant to imply that the light of justice will now create hope? Well, next chapter is called The Child of Hope, and Merlin has her hope, so if it weren't for the fact that Arthur has that annoying female voice, then I would have actually enjoyed his character a little bit more. It's the... But this seems to imply that once Arthur has this sword, then he is unstoppable. I see actually no reason, though, how that would happen, but hey, it's how power is working, and I don't complain about that. After all, I read a series about that. Still, though, what is that holy sword? If it turns out that the supreme deity really is in that sword, then we will have a problem. But next chapter is called The Child of Hope. And apparently a spread and a special present 2 weeks in a row will happen. So whatever that sword is, next week's chapter promises hope. And I guess we'll see what will be. But the author changed his opinion on Meliodas pretty quickly. Especially from whatever happened here. Never ever forgive him. Well, Meliodas have been turned into an evil character. Still though, can anyone save him from that darkness? And no one knows. It seems to imply, though, that a part of his old memories are still inside of him, despite his cruelty. So I guess we'll see. The Child of Hope will give us at least some hope next week. Give me your thoughts if you have any.